Welcome back, everyone. My name is Harpreet Singh, and I'm a customer engineer for Azure Identity with Microsoft Customer Experience team. Today, we would be learning how to troubleshoot authentication failures, which may occur due to device-based conditional access policy. Without further ado, let's dive into the scenario that we have on our hand. Here, we have a user named Jonathan who is unable to log into Azure portal and receives an error, "You cannot access this right now." When we click on more details, we see the error code 53003. When we get into more details about this error code, we simply get to know that this error is a typical conditional access policy authorization error. To start off the troubleshooting, we'll try to review the sign-in logs for this particular user. When reviewing the sign-in logs, we see that the access was blocked by a conditional access policy named Limit Azure Management on SOAR machines. When reviewing additional details, we see that access was blocked since sign-in request failed to satisfy device filter rules, which require device to be hybrid Azure AD joined and have extension attribute 1 published with value SOAR. Since the policy has device-based requirements, we browse to Device Info tab to get more details about the device being used. Here we find that user is trying to connect to Azure portal using Google Chrome on a Windows 10 machine. As per the conditional access documentation, we are aware that Chrome browser requires additional configuration to support device-based conditional access policy. Basically, we need to install Windows account extension to complete this configuration. To get more details about this configuration, you can browse to the link displayed on the video. And this might be one of the reasons why end user is getting blocked by conditional access policy since the device claims are not being presented to Azure AD. As the conditional access policy being evaluated here has two rules with an AND condition, this means the device needs to be hybrid Azure AD joined and also needs to have extension attribute 1 with the value SOAR. As a step 1, we will evaluate the device state using tsread cmd command. We will browse to end user machine, open command prompt and type in tsread cmd --status. The output of this command includes multiple sections such as tenant details, user details, and device state. We are interested here in device state section, wherein we would be evaluating the output for Azure AD join and domain join status. For our user, we see the values of these two attributes set to yes, which means the device is successfully hybrid Azure AD join. As a step 2, we will try to validate extension attributes that are applied to the device from Azure portal. From this command output, we will now copy device ID and go to Azure portal. On the Azure portal devices section, we will paste this device ID and search for the device. When reviewing this device, you would see extension attributes that are assigned to this device. Here, we see that extension attribute 1 with value SOAR is missing. From the command output, we can conclude that the device is hybrid Azure AD joined. However, the end user is not able to access Azure portal since the extension attribute 1 with value SOAR is missing and the browser that the end user is using does not have additional configuration required to get support for device claims. To fix the browser configuration issue, we'll open Google Chrome and open Chrome Web Store within it. We will then search for Windows account extension. We'll click on Add to Chrome button and click on Add Extension. This will add the extension to Chrome, and once we sign in, it will pass on the device claim for Azure AD, which will help Azure AD in conditional access policy evaluation. To fix the missing device extension attribute, we will perform a patch query on Graph Explorer with device object ID to patch the extension attribute 1 with value SOAR. To execute the patch operation, we'll browse to aka.ms/ge. We will use the device object ID and the extension attribute mentioned in the JSON body to execute this query. Once this is complete, you can perform a get operation to validate if extension attribute 1 has been published with the correct value. With both the requirements for conditional access filter for devices are in place, we can see that the end user is able to successfully log into Azure portal using Chrome browser. I hope this video helped you to learn more about how to troubleshoot authentication issue with regards to device-based conditional access policy. That's it for this video. I hope you find this useful, and you can also check out Azure Active Directory playlist for some amazing content. Till then, thank you for watching. Goodbye.